5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
When I had come down this hill, I had seen this creature cross the road. They would have ripped my locked door from my truck, extracted me from my vehicle, and there wouldn't have been a damn thing I could have done about it.
This thing, I got to notice in its eyes. Its eyes was real, real evil, real sinister looking. You know, the look it was giving me.
Hello?
Get somebody out here.
What's going on now, sir?
That son of a bitch is about 6'9", I don't know.
Do you see him now, sir?
Yes, I'm looking right at him.
Uh-oh.
Welcome to Sasquatch Chronicles, a place where people share their encounters. Let's start the show. Welcome to the show, everyone. Thanks for being here tonight. Got a great show planned for you tonight. I'll be speaking with Ginger, and Ginger had an encounter in West Texas along with her husband. Two separate encounters, but very interesting. If you've had an encounter and you'd like to be on the show, shoot me an email. My email address is wes@sasquatchchronicles.com. And Duke and I just did another conspiracy corner. Going to try and find more, I guess, less gross topics to talk about. I know that last one, there's a lot of things I wanted to put in between while we were talking, some video clips and whatnot, but some of it was hard to watch. And it's important to understand history, but some of it was very hard to watch. I hope you guys enjoyed it. The next one, I think we got kind of a fun topic, a very interesting topic. So look for that next week. On Sunday, I'll be speaking with Mark, and he was actually run off of his deer stand with his son by two of these creatures. It should be a great show for Sunday. Let's jump into it tonight. Ginger, welcome to the show. Thanks for being here.
You're welcome, Wes. Thanks for having me.
And if you would, kind of start from the very beginning. Tell us how all of this started, and then if you would, just kind of walk us into your encounter.
Okay. Well, we had just moved from town. We bought a place out in the country, and it's, like I said, it's about 13 miles, I would say, southwest of San Angelo, and we bought 5 acres with a pecan orchard. It's a home division, and each place has 5 to 10 acre lots, and it's also between two creeks, Spring Creek and Dove Creek, and our little pecan orchard was on a dead-end road, and we were the last house there that was out of the flood zone. All of the other places around us were in the flood zone, so they were just vacation places. People were only there on the weekends. Some places, we didn't even see anyone there. So we didn't have a lot of neighbors, and we loved it. We absolutely loved that place. And it was we had moved there in the summer of 2013, and we had our sighting the winter of 2013. We moved there almost a year ago. We moved there in June of 2013. And when I had my sighting, I want to say it was fall, close to winter. All of the leaves were off the trees. and I was vacuuming in the early morning. Caleb had already gone to work, and I was there with my little girl, and she was playing somewhere. And I looked out the window, and I'm not sure what caught my eye, if it was movement, but I thought one of my neighbors were down at their property. They have a really nice piece of property, and they keep their, the first part of their property is wooded with a lot of mesquite trees. And it's really nice. It's really well kept, and they have like a jogging track around their property, and they have this pile of wood, a wood stack there, and I thought it was my neighbor, and I thought they were stacking some wood. And one of the first things I thought was I'd never seen them there during the week, and this was the weekday. And another thing is that we live on a dead-end road, and their house is the last house. There's a dead-end road. And my dogs, I have three dogs, and they bark like crazy whenever anyone shows up. So I was really surprised at those two things. And I took a moment to see what they were doing. I guess being a nosy neighbor, I just wanted to check out what they were doing. And it was kind of overcast that day, and it was a silhouette of a person down there. I didn't make out any clothes or anything. I couldn't see any facial features or anything like that, but it was just a silhouette of a person. And when I stopped vacuuming and looked out there, the first thing I noticed was that they didn't have any clothes on, and they didn't have any shoes on. And the head looked like a mountain gorilla on this person. And when I saw the head, the first thing that came to mind was it was a mountain gorilla. And it being a neighbor or a person at that point was like, it's not a person. It's a mountain gorilla. And then I would look from the head and shoulders down and I could see legs. And I'm like, well, it's a person. Then I look up and I think, no, it's an animal. It's a gorilla. And I was really confused. I could just not figure out what it was. And it was my sequence of thoughts that I had never experienced in my life of seeing something and having my mind try everything it could to talk me out of what I was looking at. And it just didn't make any sense.
How far away from you was the creature?
It was about 300 yards away.
And was it proportioned like a person, or was it proportioned like a gorilla?
From the shoulders up was proportioned like a gorilla. But when I every time I would look at that part of it, I just was like, it's a gorilla. It just looked exactly like a mountain gorilla it had a cone-shaped head. And it had huge shoulders, and it had really long arms. And it was in, the stance that it was standing in was almost in like a mid-movement. Like it looked, to me it looked like it was just holding still. And that, I thought when I was looking at it, like, and I don't know how to explain, I don't feel like, you know, it was sending me any kind of messages or something. I just thought like it could see me and it was holding still. That just came to my mind, and I thought it was like looking at me, like it could tell I was looking at it. At first I couldn't, well, it was, the shins were behind, or at first when I noticed it, the shins, it, the way it was placed in like that wooded area, I thought at first that it was standing behind the wood stack, and it was hard to tell the distance because the shins were so small compared to its legs. I couldn't make sense of it. I couldn't tell if it was behind it or in front of it. And then I noticed that there weren't any branches in front of it. It seemed like it was, instead of on the far edge of this forested area, it was on the edge closest to me. And it looked like the tree it was next to, like it was, one of its hands was almost like wrapped around it. like it was